All right, class, a very good morning. Wishing you all are healthy and happy. Let's discuss with the chemistry's topic. In yesterday's class, due to some reasons, I couldn't teach you with the help of whiteboard. But the topic and the concept was very easy, and I'm sure that everyone has got this concept, okay? The topic we understood yesterday was the water. We have studied that if there is a normal water, that is going to be soft water, but if there are some impurities only due to two metal compounds like calcium and magnesium, if calcium and magnesium is present in their compound or then their ions, they will make our water hard. Okay, this we have studied, this we have already understood, and we also have come to know that this is of two type. One is temporary hardness and second one is permanent hardness. Okay. And in the temporary hardness, in the permanent hardness, the only difference is, I have told you calcium and magnesium would be over there, so we cannot change them. The only difference is, in the temporary hardness, there is bicarbonate ions, whereas there is chloride and sulfate ion. Clear? All right. So this is what we have already understood in our yesterday's topic. Moreover, we have come to know that the temporary hardness of water can be easily removed, because this is temporary, so it can be easily removed by two simple methods. One is boiling and second one is Clark's method. If we just boil our water, it would the bicarbonate would be broken down and it would release in the form of carbon dioxide, so that the temporary hardness is removed. Same as it is the Clark's method, which contains the sodium metal compound. The sodium metal compound would replace the calcium magnesium and would make a precipitate, so that the soluble impurities, these everyone is the soluble impurities, would make into insoluble precipitate, and by filtration we can easily remove it, right? And in the permanent hardness, there are totally four methods for removing the hardness. And we have understood the two topic over there. First one was the Kellgren's method. This contains sodium hexaphosphate, or we can say sodium hexametaphosphate, okay? This has the same principle, this has the same concept, I would like to say, that it would remove our compound with the help of making it into insoluble precipitate. Okay? Now let's move to our next topic, that is, what are the two concepts of removing the permanent hardness? Let's begin with the new principle, the new method, that is the ion exchange method. Let's start. The ion exchange method. Okay, see class, as I have told you, ion exchange method. As the name suggests, we need to exchange the cation, we need to exchange the metal ion with the help of a compound which has the ability to remove it. मैं दोबारा रिपीट कर रही हूँ. वी हैव अ कंसेप्ट, वी हैव अ प्रिंसिपल दैट इन आयन एक्सचेंज मेथड वी रिप्लेस द मेटल आयन और एक्सचेंज द मेटल आयन. सिंस आवर मेटल आयन इज इन अ पॉजिटिव चार्ज, सो इट इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज केटायन, राइट? वी हैव मैग्नीशियम टू पॉजिटिव एंड कैल्शियम टू पॉजिटिव. सो वी नीड टू हैव अ पर्टिकुलर मेटल विच हैज द कैपेसिटी to exchange that particular cation, which has the more reactivity to exchange that particular ion. Okay, so we are using sodium method. So in the last methods we have used in the previous two, the Kellgren's method and other was sodium carbonate. What we have done, we have taken the sodium compound. In the very same way, we are taking a compound which is made up of sodium, and it would replace the magnesium and calcium two positive very easily by making insoluble precipitate. Am I clear or not? Let's take the reaction. Let's see how is it working. Give me a second, please. All right. The very first point, as I have told you, we need a sodium compound, and this sodium compound is known to be sodium aluminium silicate, the sodium aluminium silicate, which is known to be, this is known to be aluminium silicate. Now for our simplicity, we just write it NaZ. That means this is replaced by Z. This is a metal containing sodium. It would replace the magnesium or calcium. I'm writing the metal 2 positive, where metal is representing both magnesium and calcium 2 positive. It would replace very easily. And the sodium would be present in the, I would like to say, in the water. But the point is, the metal on reacting with become M2Z as a precipitate, and we can remove it. Okay, one more point, bachche. I hope that you do not have doubt in that why have we written NaZ over here, whereas we have written M2Z over here. Isme to koi doubt nahi hai na? This is very simple. In your lower classes, you have read this is due to 2 positive charge of metal. Calcium and magnesium has 2 vacancies. So according to Christgau's method, we go to M2Z. Okay, that's it. Now let's move to our next topic. That is the last one. We are getting synthetic resin method. Okay, this is MZ2 because M2 positive Z would get MZ2. Okay, now let's move to our last method that is known to be synthetic resin method. Okay, nowadays we have used, okay, a point I would like to say, bachche, in this concept, this ion exchange method is also known as zeolite method. And this method is famous in the name of zeolite rather than the ion exchange method. Okay, so the question would come, explain the zeolite method for removing hardness of water. Okay. Now let's move to the last topic, that is synthetic resin method. If we talk about the synthetic resin method, what's happening actually over there? In synthetic resin method, the method is quite efficient than the previous one. I would like to say this method is much efficient than the zeolite method. We have created the resin, that's why it is called synthetic. We have created potential resin, that is why it is known to be synthetic resin method. Now the point is, principle is quite same. Principle is exactly same, that moving of a particular metal, we are exchanging the metal ion. The method is very same, but the difference between the two is it works in 2 methods, that is cation exchange, resin method, and anion exchange resin method. Okay, now the point here is, bachche, as you have seen the last 3 methods to removing the permanent hardness, as well as you have seen the method for removing temporary hardness of water, in each method, there was not any kind of concept in which we have used the anion exchange. Let's understand what I want to try to say you. Cation exchange means we are exchanging the cation. And what is cation over here? The metal, quite obviously. Magnesium 2 positive and calcium 2 positive. Jaisa humne previous mein kiya tha, we have replaced the sodium metal with the help of metal 2 positive ion. Since the cation is exchanging from this compound, the cation, the Na positive, this is exchanging, this is known to be cation exchange method. Now, I just want to say you, we have understood that the permanent hardness of water is only where when we have the chloride, the sulfate ions. हमने पढ़ा था ना ये कि मेरा जो वॉटर है वो परमानेंट हार्डनेस तभी कहलाएगा अगर उसके अंदर मेटल का क्लोराइड और सल्फेट आयन प्रेजेंट है. एम आई क्लियर ऑन नोट? नाउ द पॉइंट हियर इज we can replace the metal. Metal 2 positive, that means cation. But anion exchange mein hum replace kar rahe hain apne anion ko, that means chloride and sulfate ko. Am I clear or not? This is the only method which works on the replacement of anion. It doesn't care about the metal. Isko koi farak nahi pad raha hai ki mere paas kaun si metal hai, magnesium ya calcium hai. Because wo uske saath precipitate bana hi nahi raha hai. Ye sirf aur sirf chloride aur sulfate ko replace kar raha hai. Am I clear or not? So this is known to be the synthetic resin method having two different types, cation exchange as well as anion exchange. I hope I'm clear now, Bachche. Okay, now let's see the chemical reaction, how the chemical reaction would be work. See, the very first point for understanding this concept, we can say that in cation exchange resin method, we need to replace a cation. Isiliye humne sodium metal ko use kiya tha. Okay, and we also know that sodium is much reactive than magnesium and calcium, so it would replace them. Magnesium is reactive in sodium, so it would easily replace that. But now in anion exchange, we need to exchange or we need to shift a particular anion. Hame koi negative ion chahiye jo in okay. So in this method, we will use a particular compound containing anion rather than the sodium metal. अभी तक जितने भी हमारे कंसेप्ट थे, जितने भी हमारे मेथड थे, वी हैव यूज्ड सोडियम कंपाउंड, ओके, बट दिस इज इन विच वी आर नॉट यूजिंग द मेटल, वी आर ओनली यूजिंग द एनायन. विच एनायन इज दिस एंड हाउ इज इट रिप्लेसिंग, लेट्स सी दैट. ओके, लेट्स सी द केमिकल रिएक्शन. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल ट्राई विद द कैटायन एक्सचेंज रेजिन मेथड, द फर्स्ट वन. ओके, होपफुली द मेथड इज क्लियर टू यू. कंसेप्ट बहुत ही सिंपल है, हमें सिर्फ और सिर्फ ये काम करना है कि मेरे जो सोल्यूबल इम्प्योरिटी है उसको किसी भी तरीके से इनसोल्यूबल बनाकर प्रेसिपिटेट की फॉर्म में हम उसको सेटल डाउन करा, सो दैट वी कैन इजीली फिल्टर. ओके, सो मेथड इज वेरी इजी. नाउ लेट्स स्टार्ट. ओके, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, if we are going to say that we are we are using the cation exchange method, first of all, what is the resin? Resin hai kya actually? Okay, this resin is made up of organic hydrocarbon. Okay, this is made up of organic hydrocarbons. This is my resin. Moreover, this resin is actually made up of we can say sulfate, organic hydrocarbon sulfate. But then it is reacted with the sodium chloride and this would become RNA. Why? Because we need sodium. Okay, so we can say RNA is known to be resin. Okay, another point, this Na is my positive charge, this is cation, this R is negative, so this is known to be anion resin. Am I clear or not? Pehli baat to resin hai kya? Resin sirf a chemical compound hai which is made up of organic hydrocarbons. We will see what are the organic compounds, but till now you just come to know that hydrocarbons are those compounds which contain only hydrogen and carbon. Okay, now let's see, we are having two different we can say compound over here, R negative and Na positive. Sodium is positively charged, so this should be the negative to maintain the valency, to maintain the compound neutral, so this is known to be anion resin. Okay, now this RNA, whenever reacted with water, the water contains the metal 2 positive, magnesium and calcium. So what would happen? My metal would replace this and this become an insoluble precipitate. It would settle down. It would be easily filled. Okay, that's simple. Now, another point is, as we have used the sodium metal, when we came to know further about the investigation, with the advancement, we have come to know we use can also use 2RH plus metal 2 positive. The both are the same type. This is my anion resin, negative, positive. So it would give the same concept, 2H positive. Clear? Okay. Now, this is my the half method we have done, that is cation exchange resin. Moreover, when we need to go the anion exchange resin method, second method. Now we need to shift the anion. We need to shift the negative charge. So we must contain a compound which is more reactive, which has the tendency to replace the chloride and sulfate ion. Let's see what are those. We have, it's written over there, the RNH3 positive, OH negative, plus suppose this is represented by X, where X is either chloride or sulfate. क्योंकि सिर्फ यही दो compound हैं जो present हो सकते हैं magnesium और calcium के साथ to make my water permanent hard. Okay. Now the point is, what is the RNH3 positive, OH negative? This is just made up of ammonia reaction with water. We know that this is ammonia, NH3. अगर हम उसके एक हाइड्रोजन को रिप्लेस कर दें हाइड्रोकार्बन से RnH2 plus water would make RnH3 positive OH negative. This RnH3 positive OH negative is reacted with hard water. The chloride and sulfate present in hard water would easily be replaced by OH negative because we need to shift only the negative ion. So what would we get? We would get the RnH3 positive X negative plus OH negative. Am I clear or not? Another important point, iske andar hamare paas negative charge tha, so we have told this the anion resin, whereas this is known to be cation resin. Am I clear? So don't confuse between the two. This is anion exchange method, but we are using cation resin. Same as it is, this is cation exchange method, but we are using anion resin. हमें सिर्फ cation को exchange करना है, मेरी resin जो है, उसको neutral करने के लिए opposite charge. Okay? Okay, one more point. When we have done this method, when we have completed our reaction completely, what we are left? We are left with H positive and OH negative. This H positive and OH negative would further react to make water, and the reaction is completed. Clear? So this is how my water is used, or I would like to say my hard water has completely freed from the hardness. Either it is temporary or the permanent. Clear? Okay. Abhi tak bache, bahut hi simple method hai. I hope you have understood. And you must have come to know ki humne har ek method mein sodium metal ke compound ko liya hai. Okay, so the principle is same. Only the different principle is the resin method in which we are using anion exchange method. Okay, otherwise every method is same. So this is how we can say what is my hard water, what is my soft water. Moreover, how can we remove the temporary and the permanent hardness of water? This have been done. Clear? Now, this chapter has been left with only three topics, that is hydrogen peroxide, heavy water, and last one is hydrogen economy. Okay, so the hydrogen peroxide is little lengthy. We cannot do this right now. The very two topics are super short and it's very simple. Let's talk about those topics. What is heavy water and what do you mean by hydrogen economy? Okay, let's start. The heavy water is very important compound, plus very important question for your MCQ. In MCQ, 110% you will get the question, what is heavy water? Okay, let's see what is heavy water. Why do we call it heavy water? Another question. Hai to water hi, fir usme aisa kya hoga ki hum usko heavy water bol rahe hain. This is, it contains the heaviness. Okay, let's see. The next topic is heavy water. So you know very well, this is known to be my water. This is my simple water. Another point is, we are reading the chapter hydrogen. Aur jab humne apne chapter ko start kiya tha, we have understood that my hydrogen has three different isotopes, that is protium, deuterium, tritium. Right? Protium, deuterium, tritium. This is represented by 1H only. This is represented by deuterium, that is D. And this is represented by tritium, T. Another point I have said, that tritium is very rare to be found. It's just 0.01% present on the earth. Another point is, it is very radioactive. So we cannot use it for our purposes. Okay. But heavy water, this is almost 1% present on the earth. So we can use it. Moreover, it is stable. It is not radioactive. Okay, so if we replace the isotope of hydrogen from the protium to the deuterium, we will get the heavy water. Am I clear? So heavy water is nothing. It is the water containing the isotope of hydrogen known as deuterium. That is two hydrogen. Clear? This is a very simple question. Now the point is, why do we call it heavy water? Because it is used as a moderator in the nuclear reactor. Nuclear reactor means there are so many nuclear reactions. You have heard, like I'm talking about nuclear fission, nuclear fusion. आपने कभी थोड़ा बहुत इनके बारे में स्टडी किया हो, और यू हैव हर्ड अबाउट द न्यूक्लियर बॉम्ब, द एटॉमिक बॉम्ब, है ना? दे कंटेन अ चेन रिएक्शन व्हिच इज सुपर सुपर फास्ट. ओके, सो इफ वी यूज ड्यूटेरियम ऑक्साइड, इफ वी यूज ड्यूटेरियम ऑक्साइड एज हैवी वॉटर, व्हाट वुड हैपन? इट वुड इजिली स्लो डाउन द न्यूक्लियर रिएक्टर. मॉडरेटर मीन्स जो रिएक्शन बहुत फास्ट है उसको स्लो करने में यूजफुल है. दैट इज व्हाई दिस इज कॉल्ड टू बी हैवी वॉटर. ओके, दिस इज द मेन इंपॉर्टेंट पर्पस फॉर यूजिंग हैवी वॉटर. अनदर इज, वी कैन मेक द कंपाउंड फ्रॉम ड्यूटेरियम, ड्यूटेरियम कंटेनिंग कंपाउंड लाइक कैल्शियम ड्यूटेरियम, CaD2, लाइक CH2, और वी कैन से अनदर कंसेप्ट वी हैव, लेट्स चेक, दीज आर, yes, C2D2, which is replaced by C2H2, and CD4, which is replaced by CH4, methane se hum CD4. So these are the compounds which can be made by deuterium oxide. Okay, that's it. So we have done the concept about the heavy water. This was so simple and short. Now let's check out about the new concept. This is my last topic of this chapter. Hydrogen economy is the last topic of this particular chapter, except hydrogen peroxide. Let's see what is hydrogen economy. See, hydrogen economy is the topic, which means we are using hydrogen for our economic purpose. Yani ise hum use kare for saving our money for our practical daily life uses. Okay, let's see how is it so. We know very well that hydrogen is a compound, or dihydrogen is a molecule which releases energy whenever it reacts with any type of another compound. It would release energy. This energy can be used for our purpose. Hence, we can say dihydrogen can act as a fuel. Am I clear or no? Now, the point here is, whenever we have checked out the energy released by the combustion energy, the dihydrogen release almost 140 kilojoule per mole, as compared to LPG, which only releases up to 43 kilojoule per mole, if I'm checking out only in the mass. Okay. So the point is, dihydrogen first of all releases almost 3 times more energy. Pehli baat to ye ho gayi. It would release almost 3 times more energy, thrice energy than the LPG. Second point, not only LPG, if I'm talking about the petrol, the kerosene oil, this would release a great amount of pollutant, right? This would increase the pollution. So we have the two choice, we have the two point. First one is for having much energy, and second one is we have the less amount of pollution in this case. Due to these two reasons, we can use dihydrogen as a fuel source, as an energy source, and this is known to be H2 as a fuel. Okay. Now the point is, we have told it economy. My point here is dihydrogen is a gas. Okay. First of all, to make it for our purpose, to make it for our useful, we have to liquefy it. We need to liquefaction of dihydrogen gas so that we would, contain it, we would store it in a small beaker, or we can say small cylinder type of thing or material. Okay. So first of all, we would liquefy the dihydrogen gas by the help of decreasing the temperature or increasing the pressure, so that the molecule of dihydrogen would become close to each other and it would be liquefaction. Okay. So hydrogen economy means we are using liquid hydrogen as a source of energy, so that we will get greater amount of energy as well as less amount of pollution. This is known to be hydrogen economy. But the point is, this process is quite expensive, because first of all, I have to take my hydrogen gas, make it into liquefaction. We need many big apparatus and such things. So scientists are working on this topic, that how we can liquefy the gas very easily without using less amount of money, or without more expense. Okay. So hydrogen economy is a topic which is under process. This is not a complete topic. This is a topic which is under process. And that's why we call it the hydrogen economy, because this is a topic for the future. Okay. You have understood the concept. This is liquid hydrogen, which is a source of energy. And this is used in the rockets, fuels, or in the space research fuels, we can see. Where in these cases, we have used it. Nowadays, we are trying to use it for the